Good morning, students.
Today we are going to see the taste of divisibility from our topic playing with numbers.
Okay, now from the word taste of divisibility, we have already learned about this, the taste of divisibility, in the earlier classes. Okay, we have learned about the taste of divisibility by 10, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 11, right? So only by the rule we have learned about which number is divisible by 10, which number is divisible by 4, which number is divisible by 3, 6, or which number is divisible by 8, 11, etc. Right? Means just which number is completely divisible by this given number, and that particular number is followed the test of divisibility, right? But here, if the number is divisible by 10, if the number is divisible by 5, if the number is divisible by 3 or 9, then we have to see what is the reason behind that. Okay, so here first we will see the simply the test of divisibility by 10. We know that already. So what is the test of divisibility by 10? So suppose the number 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and so on. Okay, all these numbers are the multiples of 10, right? So 10 ones are 10, 10 twos are 20, 10 threes are 30, 10 fours are 40, and so on. So many numbers, means 2 digit, 3 digit, 4 digit, all are the multiples of 10. So that number is completely divisible by 10, correct? So if the unit place number is 0, only and only the 0, then that number is divisible by 10. So these numbers are follow the test of divisibility by 10. Okay, so these all are which type of number? Even number. Then suppose the 11, 12, 13, 14, okay, 15, 16, and so on, other the numbers, right? So unit places are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, right? So similarly, for example, here we will take 23, 35, 97, then 81, like these numbers, 2 digit and like that, 3 digit and 4 digit and so on. Okay, so if the unit place is either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, then such numbers are not divisible by 10. Okay, so what is the test for that? To number is divisible by 10, only the units or one place is 0, then that number is divisible by 10. Okay, but why the number is divisible by 10? Why this numbers 20 is divisible by 10, or why these numbers having the unit place is 0 follows the test of divisibility by 10? That important thing we are going to learn in this topic. Okay, of course this is not hard to do, right? So only we have to remember the one rule, that is the number which is in this form, that C B A. Okay, so we will write this number in this form, which we will use this expanded form like this. So before dot 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 number means before that there is a numbers. Okay, so here C means 100 into C, which place this ones place, tens place, 100 place, like this dot 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 means there are the many places, means 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs and so on, right? So here this number we will write, so 10C plus, sorry, this number we will write in the form 100C here plus 10 into B plus this A. Okay, so simply this number which is in the form 100C plus 10B plus A. Okay, now when this number is divisible by 10, if here are the many places, see 100C means C is the any number. Okay, supposed to be 5. So 500, of course the unit place is 0, then 500 is divisible by 10. So only we can say that 500 is the multiple of 10, right? So here this 100C is divisible by 10. 10B means supposed to be, we will take that 7. So 10 sevens are 70, right? But what about A? Okay, so what is the value of A should be there, then that number is divisible by 10. Okay, so this 100C, you can take any number for the C places, right? Plus 10B, you can take any number for the place of B. But if A is only and only the 0, what is the value of A? A is only and only the 0, then that number is divisible by 10. Okay, so here we have to remember only this rule only. So when A equals to 0, so what is the A? A is your unit place, understood? So and so that only when A is the unit place is 0, A value in this rule, A value is 0, then and then only that number is divisible by 10. Understood? Now we will see the examples on this test of divisibility by 10. Okay, now for example, supposed to be, we will take this 2. Okay, so this is unit place, tens place, 100 place, 1000 place, and 10,000 place. Okay, everyone knows that, is this number is divisible by 10? Of course no, because unit place is not 0 is there, right? Or 10, this 10,002 is not a multiple of 10. Okay, but if you will see this rule, then here this 10,000 place, correct na? So here 1 multiply by, or we will write here 10,000 multiply by 1 plus here 1000 places is, of course here 0 means 1000 multiply by 0 plus here 100 multiply by 0 plus 10 multiply by 0. So if you will simplify this, you will get only 10,000, correct? So here plus, here 2 means this 2 is there, correct? So unit place is here we got 2, so this number is not divisible by 10. So it means that this is the A value, this is your A, A is other than 0, correct? And number, when possible it is divisible by 10, when A is only and only 0, understood? Now we will see the test of divisibility by 5. Test of divisibility by 5, first we will see the some numbers, okay? So this 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, and so on. If you will see these numbers, then this is only the single number 5. Okay, all are these multiples of 5, you know that, right? So 5, this is unit place and one digit number is there. Here 2 digit number, what is the ones place? 0. Here ones place 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, right? So this, all these numbers are divisible by 5, means they are following the test of divisibility by 5. So we can say that if the unit place of the number is either 5 or 0, correct? If you will see this number, alternatively the unit places are 0 or 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, and so on, right? So when once digit is 0 or either 5, then that number is divisible by 5. Okay, now we will see by using the rule. So here the same rule, we will use this number which is in the form this plus 100C plus 10B plus A, means here this number is CBA. Dotted means what? There are many places before this, correct? C place, right? So C place means what is the value of C? 100C. So you can take any number, any 9, 4, 5, then you will get 900, 500, 400 and so on. That all these numbers are divisible by 10 as well as these numbers are, see, 100 into 5. So you will get 500, correct? So what is the unit place here? 0, right? Alternatively, so we have to want 5 unit place, correct? So this 500, then this is 10B means you can take any number in the place of B. So you will get 10B means supposed to be 10 multiplied by 7. So it is 10 sevens are 70, right? Or if you will take here 3, then 10 threes are 30. Is the 30 is the multiple of 5? Yes, of course, right? So this also number is multiple of 5. So B, you can take any number, but what about the A? Okay, if you will take this A, is to be 1 or 3 or 7, correct? Then is it possible? Means you can take if 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 6, 8. Is it possible this number is divisible by 5? Of course not. Means A should be there, 0. Then here you will get 500, this 10 threes are 30 and this 0, okay? So here 30 and this 0, so you will get 530, right? But other than if you will take this in place of this A, what is the A? If you will take 7, then you will get 537, correct? So this is not possible. The 537 is divisible by 5 because once digit should be 0 or 5. Okay, so here the in that rule, the A here, A should be 0 or A should be 5, then and then only that number is divisible by 5. So this is the test of divisibility by 5 when the any number having ones place is either 0 or either 5, then and then only that number is divisible by 5. Understood? We will see the examples on this. If the division n divided by 5, means here n is the any number that divided by 5 leaves a remainder of 3, what might be the ones digit of n? Okay, here n is the one of the number and we have to divide this number by 5. Okay, now see, if you will see that division in that multiples of the 5. Okay, so 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 15, correct? Then 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, dash, so on, so 55, dash, 95 and so on. Okay, so if you will see very properly these numbers, we want what is the remainder? 3. If the remainder is 3, then what number should be there? Such a number that the unit place is what should be there, then that number is divisible by 5 and the remainder will come 3. Okay, we have to find out the n is the one of the number when it is divided by 5, then the remainder must be 3. Then what is the unit place of that number, that n, that we have to find out. Okay, so here we want the remainder 3, correct? If you will divide this number 5 divided by 5, then you will get remainder, means 5 ones are 5, right? Like this way, 5. Okay, 5 divided by 5, 5 ones are 5, so you will get 0. Similarly here, 10 divided by 5, so 5 twos are 10, it's completely divisible by 5, so you will get remainder 0. But we want, what is the remainder? We want remainder is 3, right? And we have to find the such a number having what should be the unit place, right? So if you will add in this 10 plus 3, and if you will follow the division here, 10 plus 3 is what? 13, correct? So here 13 divided by 5, so 5 2s are 10, so you will get remainder is 3, right? So when this number is divisible by 5 and the remainder will come 3, then what should be the unit place of this number? So of course, what number should be there? 3, correct? So 10, when 10 in place of unit place, there is a 3, so 13 will be there, then that number, if you divide by 5, then you will get remainder 3, correct? Now we will see the next one example. Suppose 30, okay? So here 30, right? So 30 means this number is completely divisible by 5, right? So this number is completely divisible by 5, then you will get remainder 0 here. 5, 6 are 30. So this is the remainder, understood? This is remainder, but we want the remainder is 3. So here in the 30 plus 3 you will do, then you will get 33. And if you will divide this 33 by 5, then you will get remainder 3, understood? So what is the ones digit of this number? N, we have to consider this number, or we have to take this number as a N. So what is the ones place or ones digit of this N? N is of course 3. Another one, we will take this number supposed to be 45, okay? So 45 is of course divisible by 5. 5 9s are 45. If you do the, or if you carry the division, this 45 divided by 5, 5 9s are 45, completely divisible by 5. So what is the remainder here? 0. But we want the remainder is 3. Then here 45, in that if you will add 3, so you will get 48, okay? Now if you will carry this, if you will get, take here this 48 divided by 5, so 5 9s are 45, so after carrying division you will get 3. So this is your remainder, correct? So when n divided by 5 leaves the remainder 3, so what might be the ones digit of n? So all are this n only, this n, okay? This also n, then here this also n, right? So when, what is the unit place here? This 3, here also this 3, here this 8, okay? So when n divided by 5 leaves a remainder 3, then what might be the ones digit of n? Of course, they are 3 or 8, okay? So when in the unit place of any number, if there are 3 or 8, if there are 3 or 8, then only possible their remainders come 3, and that number is divisible by 5, means the numbers divides when 5, then there is a remainder will come 3, understood? Now we will see the same next example. Now here, suppose we will take this number 5, so 5 divided by 5, you are getting remainder 5, 1s are 5, means you are getting remainder 0, but remainder here got 0, okay? So here if you will take this 6 divided by 5, so you will get 5 ones are 5, means remaining will come, remainder will come 1, correct? Now we will check this number 10. So 10 of course divisible by 5, 5 2s are 10, so we will replace this 0 with 1, so 5, 11 divided by 5, you will get 5 2s are 10, so what is the remainder will come? 1. Remainder will come 1, so we want remainder 1 only, right? Then another example, in that supposed to be 11, we will write it is 12 divided by 5, so 5 2s are 10, you are getting remainder 2, right? And if 13 divided by 5, so 5 2s are 10, you are getting remainder is 3, right? So similarly, if you will observe, or similarly if you will check the another numbers, so supposed to be 35, Okay, so 35 divided by 5, you will get remainder 0. If 35, 5 will replace with the 6. So here 5, 6 are 30, 5, 7 are 35. So 5, 7 are 35, you are getting here remainder is 1. Okay, so this is the number n. So what is the unit place here? One's digit of this n number is 6. Okay, now the same we will check this number 45. So 45, of course everyone knows that 45 is divisible by 5. Completely divisible by 5 means remainder will come 0. So if it is 48, we will take this 48. So 48 divided by 5. If you will do the division, 48 divided by 5. So 5 9s are 45, you will get remainder here 3, correct? But we want, what is the remainder? 1. So is it possible here? No. So another number, if you will here, instead of 45, you will take 46 divided by 5, right? So 46 divided by 5, so 5 9s are 45, okay? 46 divided by 5, 5 9s are 45, so you are getting remainder is 1, correct? So in this case, 46 divided by 5, you are getting remainder 1. In this case, 36 divided by 5, you are getting remainder 1. Here in this case, 11 divided by 5, you are getting remainder 1, and in this case also you are getting remainder 1. So 6 divided. When the unit place of such a number is 1 or 6, then the remainder will come 1 when it is divisible by 5. Understood? So here n is the number having the unit place is, unit places are either 1 or 6. Okay, then after carrying the division with the 5, means after dividing such a number by 5, you will get the remainder 1. Understood? Next, test of divisibility by 2. Okay, so we learn about the test of divisibility by 2, right? So what should be the unit places are there? 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then that number is completely divisible by 2, right? So that is called test of divisibility by 2. So here we know that the even numbers 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, right, and so on. So if you will see properly this series, then 2 is the unit digit, ones digit itself, 4, 6, 8, ones digit play number, then 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22 and so on. So if you will observe this, the unit places are 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 0, 2 and so on. So all these are numbers, right, and 0. So when the unit places of such a numbers are 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then that number is divisible by 2, okay, because all these are the multiples of 2. So these numbers are completely divisible by 2, means remainder will come 0. Understood? Now similarly, if you see these odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 3, 13, 15, 17 and 21 and so on, okay. So here these, all these 3, 4 numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers are ones digit number, right? So here 11, 13 and these numbers are 2 digit number, so on, like this 3, 4 digit number will be there, correct? So this 1, 3, 5, 7, again 1 came, right? So 1, 3, 5 and 7, all these numbers are in the unit places, right? So here one number 17, then 19, 21 and so on. So all these numbers in the unit places 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and again 1 came, right? So on this, like this number will come. So when these numbers in the unit places such numbers are not multiples of, these numbers are not multiples of 2, correct? It means that these numbers are not divisible by 2, right? So when you will carry this division, so what remainder will come here? 1, right? What remainder will come here? 3. Then with this n numbers when divisible by 2, or when n numbers divided by 2, you will get remainders are as 1, 3, if the digit having the unit places are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9, such numbers are not divisible by 2, okay? Understood? Now we will see the rule here, C, B, A, this number is written in this form, C, B, A. Of course, C, B are divisible by 2, then why and why not C, B, A, correct? So here, C means we will write 100 into C, means this ones place, units place, tens place and 100 place. So 100 multiplied by C plus 10 multiplied by B plus this A. What should be the value of A? Then such a number is divisible by 2. Right? And what numbers, what is the value of A, then that number is not divisible by 2, that we will see. Okay, now 100 into C, C you will keep any number 4, 5, 6, then that are the multiples of 100, right? So that also the multiples of 10, okay, also the multiples of 5, because supposed to be, suppose this is 100 multiplied by 5, so you will get 500, okay? This number is divisible by 10, of course. This number is divisible by 5. This number is divisible by 2 because the unit place is 0, correct? So 100 is divisible by, similarly this 10 B also means plus 10 multiplied by, you will take any number, 10 7s are 70. The same 70 means what here? Unit place is 0, right? So this number is of course divisible by 10, divisible by 5, correct? And of course this number is divisible by 2 because unit place is 0. But if you will take here 7, right? Is the 7 is the multiple of 2? Of course not. See here in this series, no, correct? So 7 is here only. So this is the odd number, right? So if you will keep here 7, then you will get whole number is 577, right? So that number means unit place is, if the 7, that number is not divisible by 2, right? So if you will keep here this 5, is it possible this number is divisible by 2? No, because 5 is odd number, right? 5 is odd number, so it is not possible, correct? So 6, if you will keep, 6 is even number, right? 6 is even number, then is it possible by divisible by 2? Of course yes, because unit place is 6. So either this number 2, 4, 6 or 8, if it is there, or 0, right? 2, 4, 6, 8, if it is in the place of A, means in the unit place, then only that number is multiple by, multiple of 2, or then it is, that number is divisible by 2. So what should be here? A is supposed to be 0, or supposed to be 2, supposed to be 6, supposed to be 8, then such a number which is in the form of CBA, then that number is divisible by 2. Understood? And this is the test of divisibility by 2. Okay. Now we will see the next test. Now we will see the next test of divisibility by 9 or 3. Okay. Now we will see this. What is the test of divisibility by 9? What is the test of divisibility by 3? That we will see with the example. Okay, so suppose here the number is 3573, and next one example is supposed to be 3576, correct? Now we will see what is the expanded form of this number. 3 multiply by this unit place, tens place, 100 and 1000. Okay, so 3 multiply by 1000 plus 5 multiply by 100. Correct? Plus 10 multiply by or 7 multiply by 10 plus 3 only. Correct? So here, see again I am changing this number in the another way. So here 3 is as it is multiplied by, how you will get 1999 plus 1, correct? So 999 plus 1 plus this 5 as it is, how you will write 199 plus 1, correct? Then plus 7 into 10 you will write 9 plus 1, 10 and this plus 3. Okay, now here 3 multiply by 99. Okay, so this number is multiple of this. Here you are getting 3 multiply by 999 plus 3 ones are 3. Correct? 3 into 999 plus, here plus sign, so plus 3 multiply by 1, 3 ones are 3. Similarly, okay, I will write here 99 plus 3 multiply by 1, so that is 3 ones are 3, plus here 5 multiply by 99 plus 5 ones are 5, okay, plus 7 multiply by 9 plus 7 ones are 7 and this plus 3. Okay, so this plus 3, right? Now here I will keep as it is this number, 3 into 999 plus 5 into 99 plus 7 into 9, okay, plus in another bracket I will take this 3 ones are 3 plus this 5 ones are 5 plus this 7 ones are 7, okay, and plus this 3, right? All this number, if we'll add this number, this bracket we have to simplify. 5 plus 3, 8, right? 8 plus 7, 15. 15 plus 3, 18, okay? 7 plus 3, 10. 10 plus 5, 15 plus 3, 18. So here, some of these numbers, you are getting here what? 18, okay? Now, this 18 is the multiple of 3. Yes, of course, 3, 6 are 18, correct? Is the 18 is multiple of 9? Yes, of course, what? 9, 2 are 18, okay? Now, this 18 is, or 18 divisible by 3, and 18 is also divisible by 9, completely divisible by 9. Okay, so this number follows the test of divisibility by 3 and 9. So what is the rule of test of divisibility by 9? See, if you will see this properly, 3, 5, 7, 3. Okay, 3, 5, 7, 3. All the numbers, all these numbers or all these are the digits of this 4 digit number, okay? All are, these are the digits of this 4 digit number. This is your 4 digit numbers and all are, these are digits itself, okay? So when sum of all the digits of the given number, sum means here addition, 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 3, okay? Sum of all the digits of given number is divisible by 3 or is divisible by 9, then total number is divisible by 9 or 3, means this is called the test of divisibility by 3. Understood? Now we will see actually what is the divisibility by 9 and also what is the divisibility by 3. Now we will see the next example, this place, tens place, 100 place, okay, and this is 1000 place, correct? So here we will write this expanded form, 3 multiply by 1000 plus 5 multiply by 100 plus 7 multiply by 10 plus 6. Correct? Now, again we will write 3 multiply by 1000. How we will write? 999 plus 1. Okay? Plus 5 in bracket 100 you will write 99 plus 1. Okay? Plus 7 into 10 you will write 9 plus 1 plus 6. Correct? Now here we will multiply like this. 3 multiply by 999 plus 3 ones are 3. Okay? Plus here 5 into 99 plus 5 ones are 5. Right? Plus 7 into 9 plus 7 ones are 7 and this plus 6. Okay, now here this we will take together number, correct? Now we will see, take this number here, 3 multiply by 9 plus 5 multiply by 99 plus 7 multiply by 9 plus all these number singles, that number we will take together. 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 6. Now we have to see only this number. Okay. So this 3 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 6. All if you will take this single digits or single number, then that numbers are here. 3, 5, 7 and 6. Okay. Now we will make the addition. 3 plus 5, 8. 8 plus 7, 15. 15 plus 6. What is the sum of these all numbers is 21. Okay, now we have to check whether this 21 number is multiple of 3 or 9 or both 3 or 9. 3 and 9. Okay, so 21 is of course 3, 7s are 21. Right, so 21 is multiple of 3. But what about the 9? Is the 21 is multiple of 9? No, if you will recite the table of 9, it is not multiple of 9, okay? So, when the number is divisible by 3, when the sum of all the digits in the given number is divisible by 3, then it number is divisible by 3, right? When sum of all the numbers, when the sum of the digits of the given digit is divisible by 3, then whole number is divisible by 3. Understood? If you will carry this division, you will understand that 3, 5, 7, 6 divided by 3. 3 ones are 3. Remaining 0, then carry out here 5. 3 ones are 3, remaining 2, then 27 here, 3 nines are 27, then 0, 0, then carry out this 6, 3 twos are 6, you are getting the remainder 0. Okay, so when the sum of all the digits in the given number is divisible by 3, then that number is divisible by 3. Correct? But when the sum of all the numbers is divisible by 3 and 9, then whole number is divisible by 3 and 9. Okay? Now we will see the examples on this. Okay, now we will see the example. Check the divisibility of the following numbers by 9. First one, 108. 294 and 927. Okay, we have to check whether these numbers are divisible by 9. Okay, so simply how to do this? See, 1 plus 0 plus 8. Okay, then here 1 plus 8 is what? 9. So is the 9 is the multiple of 9? Yes. So this number is divisible by 9. Okay, so this number follows the test of divisibility by 9. Similarly, this 200, 2 plus 9 plus 4. Means simply we have to see the sum of the digits of given digit, whether it is the divisible by 9, then whole number is divisible by 9, that we have learned in the previous examples in the test of divisibility of 9 or 3. Understood? So here no need to make this 2 multiply by 100 plus 9 multiply by 10, just simply for understanding we have learned that. So here only to make the sum of all the numbers, or we have to make the sum of the all the digits in the given number, and we have to check whether it is divisible by 9. If it is, then the whole number is also divisible by 9. Okay, so 9, 2 plus 9, 11, 11 plus 4, how many? 15. Okay, so is the 15 divisible by 9, or is the 15 is the multiple of 9? Of course no. So this number is not divisible by 9. Correct? It is not divisible by 9. Okay. So is it possible this number is divisible by 3? Yes, because 15 is the multiple of 3. 3 5s are 15. Okay. So whole number is also divisible by 3. But here this number having the sum of all digits is 15. So 15 is not multiple of 9. So this number is not divisible by 9. This number means whole this number is not divisible by 9. Understood? Now we will see the next example. Here 9 plus 2 plus 7. So 9 plus 2, 11. 11 plus 7, 18. Correct? So is 18 is the multiple of 9? Yes, of course. 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18. Correct? So 18 is divisible by 9. Right? So here whole number is also divisible by 9. Understood? So 927 is divisible by 9. Okay? 927 is divisible by 9. Why? Because sum of all the digits in the given number is divisible by 9. So 927 is divisible by 9. Understood? Thank you.